Hello everyone. Consider one example. Ramesh has 6 marbles with him. He wants to arrange them in rows in such a way that each row has the same number of marbles. He arranges them in the following ways and matches the total number of marbles. In first way, he arranged the marbles in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, one marble in each row. Number of rows equal to 6. Therefore, total number of marbles equal to 1 into 6, that is 6. He arranged the marbles in second way in this method. Here, 2 marbles in each row. And number of rows here 3. Number of rows equal to 3. In each row it contains 2 marbles. Therefore, total number of marbles equal to 2 into 3, that is 6. He arranged the marbles in third way, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, 3 marbles in each row, number of rows here 2. Therefore, total number of marbles, that is 3 into 2 equal to 6. He arranged the marbles in fourth way, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Here, number of rows is 1. Therefore, total number of marbles equal to 6 into 1, that is 6. From these calculations, Ramesh observes that 6 can be written as a product of 2 numbers in different ways, as 6 equal to 1 into 6, 6 equal to 2 into 3, 6 equal to 3 into 2, and 6 equal to 6 into 1. From 6 equal to 2 into 3, it can be said that 2 and 3 exactly divide 6. 2 and 3 exactly divide 6. 2 threes are 6. The remainder become 0. 3 twos are 6. The remainder become 0. So, 2 and 3 are exact divisors of 6. From the other product, 6 equal to 1 into 6, the exact divisors of 6 are found to be 1 and 6. Thus, 1, 2, 3 and 6 are exact divisors of 6. They are called the factors of 6. So, dear students, in this class, let us learn more interesting factor about the numbers in the chapter playing with numbers. In the first one is factors and multiples. Factors and multiples. A factor of a number is an exact divisors of that number. Factor means a factor. A factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Next, multiples means multiples are what we get after multiplying the number by an integer. By an integer, it is not a fraction. It is not a fraction. Consider one example. Mary wants to find those numbers which exactly divide 4. She divides 4 by numbers less than 4 this way. In this way, she divides the number 4. 1 4 is 4, the remainder become 0. Next, she divide 2 2 is 4, the remainder become 0. Next, she divide 3 1 is 3, the remainder become 1. Next, she divide 4 1 is 4, the remainder become 0. Observe the quotient here. Here quotient is 4. The remainder is 0. So 4 equal to 1 into 4. Here quotient is 2. Remainder is 0. So 4 equal to 2 into 2. When we multiply 2 into 2, we get 4. Observe here quotient is 1. The remainder is 1. We get 4. When we multiply 3 into 1, no. Here quotient is 1, the remainder is 0. 4 equal to 4 into 1. So she finds that the number 4 can be written as 4 equal to 1 into 4, 4 equal to 2 into 2. Next, 4 equal to 4 into 1 and knows that the numbers 1, 2 and 4 are exact divisors of 4. These numbers are called factors of 4. You already learnt about multiples in your previous class. Let us see what we conclude about factors and multiples. In that, first one, is there any number which occurs as a factor of every number? Yes, it is 1. For example, 6 equal to 1 into 6, 7 equal to 7 into 1, and 8 equal to 8 into 1, 9 equal to 9 into 1, and so on. Check it for a few more numbers. We say that 1 is a factor of every number. We say that 1 is a factor of every number. Consider second one. Can 6 be a factor of itself? Yes, you can write 6 as 6 equal to 6 into 1. What about 10? What about 15? What about 18? You will find that every number can be expressed in this way. We say that every number is a factor of itself. So, every number is a factor of itself. Every number is a factor of itself. What are the factors of 18? What are the factors of 18? That is 1, 2, 3, 6, 9. What are the factors of 18? They are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18. Out of these factors, do you find any factor which does not divide 18? Try it for 36 and 45. You will find that every factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Every factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Observe here. 118 is a 18. The remainder become 0. Now divide 18 by 2. We get 2 9 is a 18. The remainder become 0. Now divide 18 by 3. We get 3 6 is a 18. The remainder become 0. Now divide 18 by 6. 6 3 is a 18. The remainder become 0. Now divide 18 by 9. 9 2 is a 18. The remainder become 0. Now divide 18 by 18. We get 18 1 is a 18. The remainder become 0. So every factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. What are the factors of 34? Factors of 34 are 1, 2, 17 and 34 itself. 34 itself. Out of these, which is the greatest factor here? Yes, it is 34 is the greatest factor. 34 is the greatest factor. The other factors 1, 2 and 17 are less than 34. So we say that every factor is less than or equal to the given number. So every factor is less than or equal to the given number. The number 76 has 5 factors. Yes. factors of 76, 1, 2, 4, 19 and 76. Observe here, 176 is 76, the remainder become 0. Now divide 76 by 2, 2, 3 is 6, 1 is remaining. 2, 8 is 16, the remainder become 0. Next, 4, 1 is 4, remaining 3, 6, 4, 9 is 36, the remainder become 0. Now divide 76 by 19. 19 4 is 76, the remainder become 0. Now divide 76 by 76, that is 76 1 is 76, the remainder become 0. So you will find that you are able to count the numbers of factors of each of these. Even how many factors does 136 or 96 have? You will find that you are able to count the number of factors of each of these. So we say that number of factors of a given numbers are finite. Number of factors of a given number are finite. Next, sixth one. What are the multiples of 7? Yes, obviously multiples of 7 are 7, 14, 21, 28, 35, 42, 49 and so on. You will find that each of these multiples is greater than or equal to 7. What will it happen with each number? Check this for multiples of 6, 9, and 10, 15, 17, 16. So we find that every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to that number. So every multiple of number is greater than or equal to that number, equal to that number. Next one, write the multiples of 5. They are, it means multiples of 5, 10, 15, 25, 20, 30, 35, 40 and so on. Do you think this list will end anywhere? No. The list is endless. Try it with multiples of 6, 7, 15, 19, 18, 3, 4, 16, etc. So we find that the number of multiples of a given number is infinite. Finally, you find that the number of multiples of a given number is infinite. is infinite. Next one, can 7 be a multiple of itself? Yes, because 7 equal to 7 into 1. Will it be true for other numbers also? Yes. 5 equal to 5 into 1. 6 equal to 6 into 1. 8 equal to 8 into 1. Try it with 12, 18, 16 and so on. Now you will find that every number is a multiple of itself. So every number is a multiple of itself. Now open your mathematics books, page number 50, exercise 3.1. Exercise 3.1. In first main, they given, write all the factors of the following number. In that first one, consider a 24. It is divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24. These are all the factors of 24. Let us check. Divide 24 by 1. 1 24 is 24. The remainder become 0. So it is completely divide. 2 12 is 24, the remainder become 0. Now divide 24 by 3. 3 8 is 24, the remainder become 0. Next, 4 6 is 24, the remainder become 0. Next, 6. 6 4 is 24, the remainder become 0. Next, 8. 8 3 is 24, the remainder become 0. Next, 12. 12 2 is 24, the remainder become 0. Now check 24 by 24. 24 1 is 24. So these are all the numbers completely divided. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24 are the factors of 20. Consider B 15. Factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. Next one, C 21. 1, 3, 7 and 21. Next we move on to second main. Write the multiples of 5. Write first 5 multiples of 5. Only 5 multiples. 5 1s are 10, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25. These are all the first 5 multiples of 5.